the Maccabiah version of the football rivalry between Brazil and Argentina.
12 years after the bridge disaster, Josh Small attempts to break his father's record.
And what is this female athlete looking for in a man? Hello and good evening, Ben.
Good evening, Mel. It's great to have you back.
Sorry I couldn't be here, but I'm here every night from now on, so let's get started.
Let's do it.
Another packed day of competition is behind us, and we are here to bring you all the exciting highlights, our usual segments, and a peek into the medal count after the third day. We're starting with the football match that occurred today between Brazil and Argentina, two teams with a long-standing rival history. Although this is not the World Cup or the Copa America, the competitive atmosphere was still in full force between these two teams today.
The Argentinians had the upper hand from the beginning, scoring early in the 17th minute after Robin headed a corner kick to the far post of the goal. Argentina was just inches away from doubling the score in the first half as the ball bounced off the pillar.
And traveling into the second half, in the 59th minute, a penalty was whistled as a foul was committed in the 16-meter area. Faiz scored from the white spot to make it 2-0, settling the final score of the game. The Argentinians will enjoy their celebration tonight and match up with France tomorrow, where they'll try to qualify from their group.
Let's take a look at the Group A table.
Hello to all the people, the Jewish people of Belgium.
I'm doing karate. Gotta say hi to everyone back home, all my friends.
So happy anniversary, husband. I love you.
I'm Eitan Zohar. I'm from Canada. I want to say hi to my family back home, and I want to say hi to all of my family.
Hi, guys.
Moving now to bowling, reporter Boaz Gorin brings us the special story of Australian competitor Josh Small. He attempted to break his father's record that was set before he died in the bridge disaster of 1997.
Yes, no record break here in Netanya, Israel, as Josh Small, the son of Greg Small, held up his part of this Maccabiah in singles 10 pins bowling. As you probably remember, Greg Small perished his life at the 15th Maccabiah opening ceremony after the tragic bridge collapse. Josh himself, his son, finished on the 23rd place on the singles match out of 44 participants, and was a bit disappointed, but he told us before that his main goal is to just be here and not break the father record, although we think he really wanted to do it.
Okay, boys, so who took the gold in the bowling competition today?
So the gold medal goes to Izzy Ashkenazi. Izzy Ashkenazi is the same guy that took the silver medal 4 years ago on the 17th Maccabiah. And another father and son relationship, another father and son story, as his father took the sixth place and they both was really excited. We talked to them right after the game. Congratulations. First of all, you won the gold medal after 4 years ago you won the silver. How does it feel?
It feels great, but it's just starting. It's part of the event. This is just the singles. It's just one medal. We are going for all the medals. We have a pretty good team, and I'm getting better, and it's not about me, it's also about the team.
What is your expectation from this Maccabiah?
We are expecting to win everything. We are here to win. We are not here to lose.
How was your game?
My game was very good. I mean, for my age to bowl with this kind of young people, it's a little bit tough, but I bowled great today. It was my dream actually to play with my son together in the couples tomorrow. We are going to try our best to play good together.
So that's it for now from Netanya, Israel. Back to you.
Thank you, Boaz. Let's find out which competitor has been hitting the books as Ben Friedman puts them to the test in the Battle of the Maccabees.
Hello, we're here in the Battle of the Maccabees. What's your name?
Jenna Brand.
Where are you from?
Virginia Beach.
What are you competing in?
Open women's soccer.
What's your name?
Russell.
What are you competing in?
Open men's soccer.
Open men's soccer. Well, what position?
I play like outside defender, mostly in the defense.
Cool. So let's start the question. What is the color of Bamba? Green, black, purple, yellow.
Yellow.
It's green.
What year was the state of Israel founded? 2,938, 1,948.
1948.
1948.
What is Bezek? A fruit company, an Israeli bee, a holy place, a phone company.
Maybe an Israeli bee.
Fruit company.
Where does Yossi Benayoun play? Beitar Jerusalem, Liverpool. Barcelona Polaco.
Liverpool.
I'm gonna have to say Barcelona.
What does Ptsatsot Lagabot mean? I don't have time now. I feel sick. Great! Too bad.
I don't have time now.
Great.
This is the end of the Battle of Maccabees. Jenna is the winner, and Jenna is not walking away from us empty-handed.
Yeah.
She's getting French fries.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
Don't eat it. It's not healthy.
I won't eat it, don't worry.
Back to you guys.
French fries, an athlete's dream prize.
Dima Kreuter, one of Israel's most promising young talents, managed to jump 2.18 meters, but couldn't break his own record as he tried to pass 2.22. The Russian, Andrei Tarashin, won the gold after he tied the Maccabiah record as 2.28 meter jump.
In the 100 meters dash, Dmitry Glushenko, the newcomer from the Ukraine, crossed at 10.57 seconds to take the gold, and Nicole Gitland from Canada secured her gold by clocking in at 11.83 seconds.
Next in our show, one chess master battled over 20 competitors. And stick around for Crazy Ruby as he relaxes in the athlete's hotel. But first, let's see what our single athletes have to offer in our M-Date segment.
My name's Nestor Dordoni. I'm Argentinian and Italian, also Jewish. And I play water polo for fun. I also play basketball, soccer. Like to party with the friends and close with my family. I think family's important. I like a good smile, smells good, you know, beautiful eyes.
Hi, I'm Kelsey. I play softball. I'm from Scottsdale, Arizona. I'm 20 years old. I don't have a boyfriend, and I'm looking for someone who's funny and good looking and athletic.
Today we're at a special chess event with Judith Polgar, who is ranked 36th in the world, a rank that includes both men and women. She competed today against over 20 players simultaneously. Our reporter Carney Henman is on the scene to see who got the checkmate from Judith. So what's happening over there, Carney?
Yes, well, we'll have to be quiet not to disturb the players, but right now Judith Polgar, which is the female champion of chess, is playing over 20 soldiers at a time from the Israeli Air Force. Just last week they were playing here at the Israeli Air Force tournament themselves, and the main competition from there came to play at a time right now against Judith.
Tell us a little about the games.
Yes, well, most of the competition here are men, so we got a chance to talk to Judith before the game, and this is what she had to say.
How are you doing, Yael?
I'm very good, thank you very much. We are here at Adar Yosef. Today we saw the finals, girls and boys in gymnastics. This is the second and the last day for the gymnastics, and it was a lovely day.
So, have you spotted the next Nadia Comaneci or Agnes Kalati?
Wow, this is a very difficult question and I don't know how to answer it, but I can tell you definitely that we saw very talented young girls and boys from Australia, from USA, from Canada, from Israel. It was a big day, a lot of surprises, and everyone enjoyed it.
Thank you for that report, Yael. It's now time to pass the mic to Danielle Breyer with five things you don't know about hitting on Israeli women.
Not exactly, Ben, but if you can't meet girls in Israel being from California, you should just give up.
Guess I need to restructure my approach. Okay, now that my ego's bruised, let's get into the facts. What do you have for us?
Here are five facts you didn't know about the Maccabiah. The second Maccabiah was held in 1935 as planned, but many of its competitors were actually Jewish immigrants pretending to be athletes to elude the British authorities. The 1938 Maccabiah was cancelled due to the complicated political circumstances at the time and wasn't held for another 12 years until 1950. The 8th Maccabiah in 1969 is remembered mainly for Mark Spitz, one of the greatest sports legends of all time. That was Spitz's second appearance in the Maccabiah, but in his first in 1965, he hadn't become famous yet. As of today, there are 179 members in the Maccabiah group on Facebook. You're welcome to join. Athletes from 18 countries took part in the first Jewish Olympics. Since then, there have been 17 Maccabiahs, with the last one hosting 7,300 athletes from 64 countries. We have definitely made some progress.
Thanks for that, Danielle. Now, let's get to know a very famous athlete who made Aliyah to Israel because of the Maccabiah Games and later became one of the most successful basketball coaches in Europe. Here's Lee Knopf with the story of David Blatt.
Who would imagine that a Jewish American would be the head coach of the Russian national team back in 1981 when I was invited to come and play for the United States Maccabiah team? That was just a little bit outside the realm of possibility, you know.
David Blatt is among the best coaches in Europe. The path to winning the European Championship with the Russian national team started with the gold medal in the Maccabiah, followed by coaching powerhouses like Dynamo Moscow, Benetton Treviso, and Maccabi Tel Aviv.
I remember so well walking into the stadium for the opening ceremony, and we were next to and near the contingent from Brazil, and the joy on their faces as they sang and danced and got everybody involved was something that was amazing. And I met many of the players from there, and I met many of the players from all the teams, and some of those eventually came to Israel for a short period of time. The last 5 years in my job as a professional basketball coach, I've lived outside of Israel. And that's after 20-some odd years of living here. The biggest thing about the country that I miss and that I feel is lacking in any other place is that feeling of avai, that's the shared experience, the togetherness of the people, the friendliness, the openness. I'm living the dream in many, many aspects of that. So that's why I feel so fortunate. And again, a lot of that, in no small part, to my experience in the Maccabiah Games. I wish, believe me, I wish everyone, if not exactly the same career path, at least the same kind of experiences that I was able to get because of the fact that I was exposed to Israel in the way that I was, and again, in no small part, to the Maccabiah Games.
Before we get to the icing on the cake with Ruby, it's time to take a glance at the medal chart. Israel's leading the pack with 67 total medals and 20 gold medals. United States is in second with 5 gold. Russia's in a close third with 4 gold. Canada has 3, and Ukraine is in fifth with 1 gold medal.
And now, Crazy Ruby arrives at the Hotel of the Athletes. Need I say more?
Hello, I'm Crazy Ruby. This is the third day of the Maccabiah Games.
Crazy Ruby! Crazy Ruby!
South Africa! Woo! South Africa!
Where are you from?
Netanya.
Netanya, okay.
Bye! You're welcome, Maccabi Israel.
Woo! Crazy Ruby! I think it's drunk. He doesn't like me. What are you competing?
Wrestling.
Really?
Yeah, yes.
So you can kill me if you want.
Maybe.
You want to kill me?
Maybe.
We have the best accent ever. Everyone likes our accent. Lucy, even you do.
No one in the world can mock the South African accent.
They just can't imitate us as...
Can you imitate their accent?
No, I cannot.
No, what?
No, I can't imitate her accent at all.
That's pretty good.
Canada, Canada.
That was fun.
I need his job.
I like mine, just mine.
That's it for us today. Thanks for joining.
We'll see you all tomorrow, same time, same place. Good night.